Hello, I'm Mike, and in this video, I'll compare Zapier with Make in the Ultimate AI Orchestration Showdown. And we'll start with connectors. Now, you'll notice Zapier has 8,000 plus apps to choose from. Now, over in make.com, they also have a bunch of connectors. In fact, 3,000 plus pre-built apps, which is nothing to shy away from. But if you have to compare like for like, if you want sheer breadth of connectors, Zapier with its 8,000 plus growing daily wins over make.com's 3,000 plus connectors. But what about polling? Hang on, wait a second. What is polling? Polling is essentially where you set up an automation to check for something that happens. For instance, you publish a YouTube video, your automation starts. Let me show you. I'll actually start by building my first automation on both platforms, and we'll start with a YouTube trigger. And I can ask it to trigger every time there's a new video on a channel. You'll notice here it's polling YouTube every 2 minutes to find when a video is published. I'll paste in my YouTube channel ID. And for the second action, I'll use Slack, and I'll get it to send me a message every time a video is published. And here's the finished test workflow, new video in channel, send Slack message. There you go, I published the Zap, and I've switched it on, so it's active. I'll make the same thing over in make.com, watch videos in a channel as a trigger, and of course, we'll select my channel ID right here as the trigger. Now I'm going to choose where to start, and we'll say from now on when a video is published. Next, we'll go ahead and add another module, and that's going to be Slack. And again, we'll create a message. Pretty straightforward setup, and again, I'll type in new video. It's pretty simple. Now that we've built this basic automation, we'll make sure to save it, and then we'll switch it on to run every, and then we can choose the trigger time. Well, instead of 15 minutes, I'm going to make it match like for like Zapier and say every 2 minutes run this scenario. Click save. And now we're up and running. The scenario is saved, and every 2 minutes, it's going to poll YouTube and send me a Slack message if a new video is published. Okay, cool. We'll leave both these tasks running inside Zapier and make.com and come back to them in a second. So now I think we understand a little bit about polling. It's essentially checking a service to see if there's something new and reporting back to you or running an automation if there is. For instance, there's a new YouTube video. Send me a Slack message. Pretty simple, right? Now, inside their help docs, Zapier elegantly explain this in more detail. They use Facebook as an example and say it's polled every 2 minutes, and that it will check for new leads and then connect to your CRM. So you'll see every 2 minutes it's looking for new data. But most importantly, right here in the help docs, it says it checks every 2 minutes, it can complete 20,000 polls per month, but Zapier does not charge for these events. So even if it's doing 20,000 polls per month, if you only get 2 new leads, what are you charged? 2 tasks. That reminds me, I should probably go and check my automations. Let's first check Zapier, and you'll see it's checking my YouTube channel every 2 minutes. I've been running this for 15 minutes now. Let's go into the Zap runs and just refresh here. Nothing. Let me double check that. Nothing. So I'm essentially being charged nothing for this automation to exist and check YouTube every 2 minutes. It will only charge me when a YouTube video is published. Now, my make.com scenario has been running for about 6 minutes, and whoa, I'm already charged 4 credits. It's going up as I speak to you. If I go into the history here, yes, we'll see every 2 minutes it's polling my YouTube channel, but I am indeed getting charged 1 credit per poll of my YouTube channel. Huh. Now, let's just do the math on that for a second. Every 2 minutes polling on Make, I get charged an operation, which means 720 checks a day, I think, if I'm checking every 2 minutes. And that's 21,600 credits a month over 30 days. So Make's core plan is $9 for 10,000 credits. 21,000 credits to monitor 1 YouTube channel would cost me $20 a month just to watch a YouTube channel. 10 automations like this on make.com, that's an eye-watering $194 a month to monitor 10 YouTube channels. On Zapier, it's free. But how about branching of automations? Well, first of all, let's switch this automation off so I don't get an eye-watering bill. And now we'll go ahead and add another module, and this time it's going to be flow control. Now you'll see there are a bunch of ways to send your data, and I think make.com really shines in the way you can route data and alter your workflows to do multiple things in one simple scenario. For instance, a router can take you off in 2 different directions, and we can set rules here as to which direction we go. So let's add in some rules. I'll click the spanner on the first line here and set up a filter. We'll call this first one OpenAI. And then for the condition, we'll say if the YouTube video description, and then we'll say contains the word OpenAI and save it. And you'll see that's my OpenAI router. So if I publish a YouTube video, I'll get a Slack message and the router will send it off this way if the description contains the word OpenAI. Now let's set up the second part. And again, it's clicking the spanner, set up a filter, and we'll call this one Grok. And again, for condition, we'll pick the YouTube description and we'll say if it contains, that's this here, and then the word Grok. So now you'll see we're routing our automation in two different directions depending on contents of the YouTube description. I absolutely love the visual style that Make.com make available for branching your automations in different directions. We can finish this up and add something else in, and we can say create a user text post. And with that all set, we'll save. So now we've got a nice route that says if the video is about OpenAI, publish it on LinkedIn. For the second part of the automation, if Grok is mentioned, let's create a post on a Facebook page. And there we go, a beautiful visual automation, new video, send Slack message. If it's about OpenAI, publish on LinkedIn. If it's about Grok, publish on Facebook. Couldn't be easier to follow. Let's do the same in Zapier. So we'll add a new step here, and it's going to be a path step. Now you'll see it splits off into two different ways. So for path A, I can actually rename this, and we can call this OpenAI again. And over here on path B, we can rename this and call this Grok. Similar to Make.com, we'll say continue if the YouTube description contains OpenAI. And we'll do the same for the Grok condition. Again, we're selecting the YouTube description. And we're saying it contains the word Grok. Okay, with me so far, we've got a new YouTube video, we're sending a Slack message, and then we're splitting off into a different path depending on whether OpenAI or Grok is mentioned. And we'll choose to share an update. And now we'll do the same for Grok, and we'll mirror the wonderful automation we just created inside Make. We'll go to a Facebook page. And now that's all set up so that, yes, based on the words mentioned in the descriptions, we either get a LinkedIn or a Facebook update. Now, this is kind of splitting hairs, but if I had to call a judgment here, I just like the way that Make shows this better than the way it looks inside Zapier. It looks way more complex and computer science-y, whereas this just looks like Lego blocks connecting. So maybe one for the Zapier design team there. A lot of these internal things do not actually count towards task usage according to the Zapier guidelines. So if you use a filter or a path step or you put something in Zapier tables or Zapier interfaces, you are not charged for that process. Same with formatter, delay, looping, subzaps, digest, Zapier manager, and even storage. Those will not cost you any of your Zapier tasks, which is pretty cool. Let me give you an example of this. Say, after sending the Slack message, I also want to record the new video to a Zapier table. I can just select tables here and create a record. And then all I have to do is enter my YouTube details into this part of the Zap. And that step is completely free. Not only do I get a free step in my automation, but Zapier tables is an overpowered way of storing data natively right inside Zapier. I can also go here and add in a module. Let's look for table. And do you know what? I don't even know if Make has its own internal table storage system. And there are times like this, AI can help me. Hey Perplexity, does Make.com have internal tables like Zapier tables? Answer in one word, yes or no. Well, there's your answer. No. So another reason I would use Zapier over Make is if I need to store a lot of internal data, that can all be done right inside the box for free, not counting towards your usage inside Zapier. With Make, you'd have to use something like Airtable or Google Sheets, which is all good and well, but it's more task cost. Now, finally, what about AI features? That is super important to me, and I'm sure you, as a business owner, you want AI to do a lot of your automated processes. Let's find out how they stack up in Zapier versus Make.com. And let's go right here after a new video is found. Let's add in a step, and we'll go for the AI by Zapier step. Now, one of the coolest things is AI by Zapier has its own prompt builder, and you can make your own custom prompts. You can also choose models. And the coolest thing is, see all these models with lightning bolts, including the latest GPT-5 models. They are free and included in your Zapier plan. The same is true if we pop open Google, you get access to some Google models as well. And of course, the free models you get are evolving with new AI company releases. So this video will probably already be out of date because new models are released all the time. Let's stick with GPT-5 Mini, Zapier provided for free. And for the prompt, I'll say, find out what this video is about and give a bunch of keywords. That's a basic prompt. But wait, because AI by Zapier actually evaluates my prompt strength and it tells me I'm weak. So all I need to do is one click improve. Okay, well, that's a way bigger prompt, and now it tells me the strength is okay. I can also map in things like the YouTube description, that might be helpful, and I might also map in, say, for instance, the YouTube title as well, so that the AI has something to go with. We can actually have output fields, so if you want a specific output to send to your next part of the automation, you generate from the prompt. And now you'll see that the AI will output the title, duration, summary, keywords, and main themes. We can actually generate a preview over here, make sure we get what we want. And there we go. We've got a video title, duration, summary, themes, and all of this is generated for us using AI by Zapier. Okay, let's do the same in Make, and we'll search for AI, and we'll use Ask Anything from the Make AI toolkit. Let's go for the same GPT-5 mini, which is not included in my make.com plan. And we'll say again, analyze video. And then we can pull in the title, the description like that. Now you'll see there's no prompt enhancer or output rules or anything like that. It's a very basic AI step. The other thing to note with Make is they recently updated their pricing. Credits replace operations as a billing metric. And most modules in Make will cost you just one operation, but if you use an AI feature, it can be dynamic. So be careful of that because your costs can change depending on how much of the AI superpowers you're actually using. Let's save that. And this for me is a little bit of a black box. I don't know what's going on or how much I'll be charged. So wrapping up on AI from both Zapier and Make.com, in my opinion, I feel Zapier has the edge. Not only do you get free models included in your plan, but also you get the prompt improver, output rules, and things like that. Make.com seems more of a black box, and I'm not quite sure how much I'm going to be charged for every run of the AI model. But one great thing to note is that MCP is supported by both Zapier and Make.com, which is huge and needed in today's age. And one extra tool that Zapier has I haven't seen in Make are agents. These are absolutely incredible. They also come with a generous free plan, meaning that you get 400 activities a month for absolutely free. But if you want to deep dive with Zapier agents, I've got another video on that that you should definitely watch that I'll link in the description down below. So there you go, Zapier or Make.com. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'm so grateful for you being there. Do let me know your thoughts down below because, of course, the chat will correct me if I've made any errors in this video. I really appreciate you being there. And YouTube is showing a video on your screen now. You should watch next. Thanks.